Wisconsin.
Start their basketball game. North comes in 15-3, South 3-15. Looks like a mismatch, Chris.
Yeah, there's no question. And the way North played this year, another great coaching job by Coach Tom DeSattel. I mean, looking at his group, he was picked seventh or something like that in the league. And, you know, right now they're tied for third. And, well, you know, I don't think they can catch DePere or Pulaski, but they could end up maybe passing Ashwaubenon. But Ashwaubenon beat Pulaski the other day. Pulaski's been unbelievable, but they lost to Ashwaubenon twice this year by 3 points total. And so a fourth place finish or a third place finish is pretty respectable for them.
South comes in with a two-game winning streak. They've played better, and that bodes well for them. But what do they have to do to stop the Northsiders?
Well, I think a key tonight for Sheboygan South is they need to put four scoring quarters together. That's for sure. That's something they're gonna.
That's easy for you to say.
That's something they're gonna have to do. And I think another key tonight is my second point is don't let Ethan go off. I would be on Ethan Guskey all over the place. I just hog him all over and let somebody else beat you. Now, last time, Davis Larson had a great game for Sheboygan North. So that's fine, but I think don't let Ethan go off. The other day, Manitowoc lost by 2 points to Sheboygan North. They let Ethan Guskey get 30 points. Well, you know, you can't let Ethan go. He's just too good of a basketball player. So that's one of the other things I thought was important. And also, you got to make sure that, you know, North doesn't shoot well. I said if North gets to 60, I think lights out. I think it's a win for North.
I think one of the things that North does really well is they penetrate, and they have so many players on the floor that can dribble well that it really makes it tough to defend. But let's talk a little bit about what does North have to do to win the basketball game.
I think something that North's done extremely well this year, despite their size, is offensive rebounds. They seem to get extra attempts at the basket by offensive rebounds. And I think you made a good point. It's, you know, their drive penetration, they seem to get teams in foul trouble, even though they struggled, I think, this year from the free throw line, but I think they got to continue with that as well. Another key I thought was turnovers. North's going to want to force turnovers against South, where South's going to have to take care of the basketball. So let's see what happens there, because it seems like North gets a lot of easy baskets off turnovers against teams, and those extra baskets that they get on turnovers make their possessions easier. You know, those are easy baskets that they can add to their, you know, their total.
Right. All right, with that, we're going to step out. There'll be a couple of short breaks. We'll come back with the starting lineups and the tip-off for this second basketball game of the North-South series.
Cable access channels ensure you the ability to exercise your First Amendment rights through the medium of television. They create opportunities for mutual communication, education, and artistic expression. Public access makes community participation possible and gives you a voice in your community and your world. Make sure everyone has a voice. Support your local public access channel.
Did you know that having diabetes puts you at risk for vision loss? I'm Dr. Robert Melendez for the American Academy of Ophthalmology. I see firsthand how vision problems can affect lives. We are urging adults with diabetes to strictly control their blood sugar levels and have dilated eye exams every year. Know your risks. Save your sight. To learn more about diabetes and eye health, visit geteyesmart.org.
I've changed apartments several times. My roommates have always been trouble. Now, because of the economy, I've had to move back home. When my mom gets drunk, she tells me everything I do is going to fail. I get into arguments with her about her drinking. Dad goes to Al-Anon family groups. I didn't think Al-Anon would work for me, but every time I go, I feel better. If someone's drinking bothers you, you might find help in an Al-Anon family group meeting right here in our community. I found support there. You can too. Call 1-888-4-ALANON or visit alanonfamilygroups.org.
Hi, I'm Rosie Greer. As a former NFL player, I know the value of teamwork. That's why I'm here with my friend and prostate cancer survivor, Charlie Wilson.
Each year, more than 32,000 die from prostate cancer. African-American men are 60% more likely to be diagnosed with the disease and more than twice as likely to die from it.
Caught early, this cancer is highly treatable.
If you're over 40, Man up. Speak to your doctor about your prostate health.
The Prostate Cancer Foundation is leading the way in discovering better treatments and cures.
Together, we can take aim against prostate cancer.
Every day, thousands of community and school groups, volunteer and government producers, technical staff and residents reach out to your community through one of the most powerful communication tools available, cable TV. PEG Access produces more new local programming each week than all the programming produced by NBC, CBS, ABC, Fox, and PBS combined. PEG Access channels provide communities with a diverse, independent, and local voice. Thank you for watching and for your continued support of public, education, and government access television.
High School's Acuity Fieldhouse getting ready to start the second game. It's under a minute. Teams are going to start coming back to their benches. I want to mention the crew. They've been working very hard tonight trying to get all the equipment to work. I know this live business is throwing us for a little bit of a loop, but we have Eric Wiesman and Richard Bartson on camera. Kerry Kautzer down in the truck. Chris Wright is doing the color, and I'm Mike Martin doing the play-by-play. And we're enjoying it. We've got a real nice crowd here in the field house. Better than the first game, I think, Chris.
Yeah, it's very nice. I also understand, I know Greg and Kelly Wagner from the south side, they've been watching our, they said, sound isn't the greatest, but we appreciate everybody out there watching us.
And call my wife, she had the same sentiments. Bill Horsch giving the sportsmanship announcement. And we're gonna be, just a second, we'll have the national anthem and then the starting lineups. Maybe we won't have the national anthem since the band left. We'll just go right into game two with the starting lineups, Kerry. And they'll be doing south first. Tim Schultz at the helm for south.
Matt Schrader, guard, senior.
I'm TJ Pitch, sophomore. And I play guard.
Jake Knuth, forward, senior year.
I'm Carter Robinson, I'm a guard, I'm a junior.
Connor Harrison, I'm a guard, I'm a sophomore.
North, of course, coached by Tom Desitel. Here's our starters.
Ethan Guske, guard, senior.
Dan Campion, guard, senior.
Davis Larson, forward, freshman.
Kevin Lang, guard, senior.
Dominic Mann, I'm a senior and a forward.
Kevin Lang has been in the starting lineup since Joe Hameister's been injured and has been doing a real nice job. He just stepped in there and has been playing real steady basketball for the Raiders. Our officials tonight are Mark Jandrin, Tim Jorgensen, and Dan Yagodinsky. They're all from the Green Bay area. I think that Jorgensen is any relation to that Jorgensen, the outstanding baseball player from a few years back?
I'm
not sure.
You know what
I'm talking about,
yeah,
right?
Yeah,
can't remember.
It does kind of look like him. It is him. Yeah, and the other two, he's the one that's tossing right here. He was an outstanding baseball player. The other two have done state basketball games as well.
Larson controls the tip over Knuth.
Yeah, Tim Jorgensen played baseball at Oshkosh. Was a great baseball player.
Guskey trying to get it inside. DeMond throws it away. Harrison with the interception. Pitch has it.
Well, I think South's going to have to shoot very well. Let's see if Matt Schrader gets to a good start. He's had some slow first halves the last couple games.
Knuth from outside, sporting a new haircut, I might add.
Yes, he is.
Lang, hard to the hoop, fouled. They're not going to say no shot. He'll get it down on, North will get it down on the baseline.
Foul on Matt Schrader.
Schrader picks up the foul, his first foul, first team foul.
Davis Larson's had a great year, number 25 for a freshman. Unbelievable, his maturity.
Larson, only a freshman. Lang in the lane, rolls off, no good. Connor Harrison with the rebound. Amundsen trying to push it, and a big scrum on the floor, and we're gonna get a jump ball. Tie-up situation. Possession arrow points Sheboygan South's way, so they'll get it out. No score, we're a minute in. That's over and back, not called. Harrison in the lane, up off the glass and in. Good drive by Connor.
Wow. Where has that been? I haven't seen something like that from him all year. Very aggressive, strong move, Connor.
Guskey on a screen, around and off. He's turned his ankle too. The defense got under him a little bit and he tipped it. He's hobbling, you can see he's in a little bit of pain.
Yeah, he's been hobbled all year by that injury.
Well, he re-injured it then. Campion put pressure on Pitch's shot. Guskey running a little better now that he's on offense, though.
Oh, he's still bending over there. You can see him there on the screen, on your TVs.
Larson's shot is blocked. Harrison did the blocking, and he gathered it in. Pitch left open. Drains a long three.
TJ's played better and better and better as the year has gone on. His scoring average continues to go up. He's up 6.8.
He's only a 10th grader. Lang nails a three. Raining threes all of a sudden.
Big dog.
5-3 South. A push not call. Probably let him play on. Schrader underneath the basket. Put it up and in.
And he's got to finish that. I was afraid he was going to worry about a free throw instead of just putting in the two.
Well, North didn't get back on defense that time. Larson lost it. Schrader going hard to the hoop. Got fouled by Campion. He'll be shooting a pair.
Well, I mentioned it the other night when we had South that that's one thing Matt does very well is he gets to the basket. Very strong player there. Boy, we're 3 minutes in and a nice start for South. Just all he wanted. And early substitutions again here for South. Now, we mentioned it the other day. Plays a lot of guys, but boy, they were running good. I don't know if I would have changed things.
Yeah. Schrader puts in a pair.
Yep, two guys out. Schrader and Pitch and Knuth. You got a 9-3 lead and already get them out.
Jordan Jackson in along with Sam Selk. Sam didn't play till later in the game last time we were there. Tyler Zietz also in. Parise in the game early for North.
Jackson in for South. Jordan.
Selk going hard. Larson, you're gonna call a travel.
It's third turnover for North already. Yeah.
South has been putting the pressure on, and that might be one of the reasons for the substitutions, Chris. Keep fresh guys on the floor as best you can. Amundsen being guarded by Lang.
Good pass by Carter with his arm.
Zietz's shot is no good, and Guskey got caught looking a little bit. He went after the shooter and didn't recover. Larson down the lane, put it up and in. Doesn't play like a freshman.
No.
9-5 South.
Bad place to be, Connor.
Intercepted by Larson and tipped out of bounds by Selk. North will keep it. Schrader back in. Knuth back in. Amundsen out. And Harrison out.
And Lang out. And Faris out.
Lucas Hayes in. And Campion back in. Lang and Paris taking a rest. A good help defense by Jordan Jackson to keep Campion from going to the hoop.
And that's, you know, again, Selk, he's left-handed. You should know to force him towards the right, not the left, but Danny had a wide open area there.
Guskey with a good idea. Almost lost his balance, but he was able to keep his feet, and he put it up and in.
I thought he traveled, actually.
I didn't think he did, because if he'd have fell down, he would have traveled. Mon with the attempted steal, couldn't get it. Schrader, up and in. Good use of the body by Matt. Shield the ball away from Hayes. Lucas Hayes picks up the foul. Coach had nice words for Dominic Mon and Noah Stengel in the article this morning.
Dominic had that big,
big basket, the winning shot.
Yep.
Hey, he can put in those short ones.
Nice move, freshman.
Wowee. That's not a freshman move, I'll tell you that.
He's 2 of 3 from the floor, and
Zietz. Inside feed to Knuth. And again, South beating North back down the floor and a steal again. Miller has it. I think if Guskey has two good ankles, he steals that pass. Miller, no good. Stengel trying to take it away from Larson. Larson wouldn't let him do it. Campion driving to the hoop. And they're gonna say no shot. Foul happened while he was driving to the basket. All on Miller. Both teams sitting with two team personals. Amundsen back in. Oh, ball tipped away. Larson, Johnny on the spot to get it though, leans in, rims it around and down.
Lucky bounce for North, and they get a lucky bounce on the rim, as well as the possible turnover.
Larson with 6 points. McLaughlin in the game for the first time. Campion tipped it away, and they're going to say it's off of South. Miller tipped it last. Good hustle by Danny Campion. Imagine this, Chris, another substitution for South. TJ pitch in, Miller coming out.
Well, they were up 10-3 or whatever when they made those substitutions to start with, and now it's a 2-point lead.
Back cut by Guskey. Good defense by Amundsen.
Wow. 5 turnovers on North, and a good thing for them is they're only down by 2.
South's biggest lead was 9-3. Campion. Larson leaning in, couldn't get it. Ball tipped around. Guskey has it. Inside feed to Larson, and he couldn't handle it.
I'll tell you, the quickness of North, I mean, they are just all over you.
You know, I think it's a good thing that Coach is leaving Guskey on the court. If nothing else, so his ankle doesn't tighten up, taking a rest. It's 13-11. There's 2:16 left in the first quarter. South on top. They have led the whole quarter.
Good job there, and a good job by Carter getting to the middle of the floor. Great
pass. And a great pass over to...
That's a goaltend, and it's called.
Stengel showing that athleticism, but...
Yeah, but it's cheating. You can't goaltend, Marty.
Well, you can try. See if you can get away with it. You try to do that all the time at Friday basketball. You never get away with it either.
Carter Robinson's just got a rocket of an arm. He made a great pass there.
Lang, kick out pass to Parise. His three-pointer is off. Larson with a strong board. Parise takes his time and loads it up. Rims off, no good. Lang throws it out to Larson. Lean in, he's fouled, and he makes the basket.
How many opportunities for Sheboygan North on the glass?
You mentioned this in the opening that we had, I think, coach had concerns about the lack of height and rebounding, and they've just been demons on the offensive board.
I mean, that's just effort by Lang. Kevin Lang, you're not like talking about a, you know, a 6'6" kid. You're talking about a 6-foot kid. Two opportunities in there, and then, of course, Larson gets involved.
And North with another offense. Outside to Larson, he loads it and nails it.
Well, of course, you give him how many opportunities? That's 5 points they got on second opportunity. It's all about your heart.
16 to 15, North taking their first lead of the ball game. Harrison with an outside feed to Zietz, his shot not in. Good tip away, getting it back to South was a pitch. North playing the man-to-man defense, rolling down to a minute left in the quarter. The ball tipped away, Larson has it. They got a two-on-one break, he keeps it, shoots it, no good. Parise tries to get it over to Larson, but it's tipped. No, it is not tipped. It'll go right to South, the turnover by the Raiders.
Holy cow, Davis Larson is, I got a statue to old Cross here for him.
Jordan Jackson in for Knuth. And Stengel coming in for Larson. Well-deserved rest for him.
I got Larson 4 of 8 from the floor, 4 rebounds already. Six offensive rebounds for North, propelling them to the lead.
North applying heavy pressure. Guskey a little late on the rotation, and South able to get it over to Jordan Jackson for an easy three, easy two. 17 to 16, South back on top.
40 seconds left.
Guskey from just inside the line, couldn't get it in, and Lang is gonna get called for a foul over the back.
That was Ethan's just second shot attempt. He's 1 of 2 so far.
.9 seconds left. Clock running, South on top, and they have the ball. Pitch, had a good look, but couldn't get it in. Jackson with the rebound, hit left-hander off the glass, no good. Connor Harrison with the rebound, does put it in. Campion on the drive, puts it in with 3 seconds left. Pitch. From 30, off the glass, and we're at the end of one. South on top, 19 to 18.
Did you know that 90% of all eye injuries can be prevented by simply wearing proper eye protection? I'm Dr. Tamara Fountain for the American Academy of Ophthalmology. I see firsthand how vision problems can affect lives. We recommend that every household keep protective eyewear on hand to use during home projects and other activities that can cause injuries. Know your risks, save your sight. To learn more about eye health, visit geteyesmart.org.
Back at North High School's Acuity Fieldhouse, getting ready to start second quarter action. North was led by Davis Larson with 11 points. Ethan Guskey played the whole quarter, tipped his ankle early on. Coach left him out there. I thought that was a good move, and Ethan moving better than he was. South had good contributions.
Matt Schrader had 6 points. TJ Pitch had 5. Connor Harrison had 4, but really did a number on the defensive end.
Both teams shooting 50%, Marty.
Guskey got in the lane, shot was no good.
Guess what?
Dominic Mann with the tip out.
Another reload.
Mann got the ball back, couldn't get the shot in, gets the rebound, fouled on the shot attempt. He'll be shooting 2. Wow. You can't write him down fast enough.
Eight offensive rebounds so far for Sheboygan North. Just outstanding, hitting the glass.
Mann ties it up at 19 with that second free throw, his first point of the night. Campion hustling back, covering up the man underneath. Schrader wide open on the other side. They don't see him.
Interesting stat, Marty. I have Sheboygan South go 7 of 9 now from 2-point, but they're 1 of 7 from 3.
That was Tyler Zietz with that last shot, not able to get it in. Campion inside to Mann. His shot is blocked by Harrison, but he gets it back. They left Campion open for a second. He puts it up but can't get it in, and then Mann tips it out of bounds. Amundsen and Hayes are going to check in.
Well, Dominic's real active underneath the basket. He's got 3 rebounds already. Dominic Mann for North.
Amundsen pressuring it in, but then he throws it away. But Harrison is able to get it back. Pitch.
Oh, that was Knuth.
No good. I knew Pitch had it and dished it off. That's what I was alluding to. Campion, I think, wanted to pass it into Hayes, but South read it and stole it away. A lot of action, not all of it good.
Slow pass has got to be quicker, Connor.
Oh, lane to the basket was wide open for Harrison, and he blew the layup. Guskey to the basket, no shot. They're gonna call it on the ground.
I have Davis Larson with 7 rebounds already, having the same impact as he did in game 1. 11 points, 7 rebounds for the freshman.
He's been on fire, that's for sure. Mann has it, puts it up and in. Nice pass by Campion.
That just should never happen.
Kind of caught him napping. Timeout, full timeout by South with 5:40 left in the first half. North on top, 21-19.
I wouldn't let my peeps drop, Brooke.
Do you?
Do you?
Do you?
I got one.
Do you?
Actually, I got 2 designated drivers, that is.
Keep your head screwed on 3. Don't drive drunk.
I don't. Do you?
Do you?
Do you? Don't drink and drive. We don't.
Do you?
Brought to you by Rad, Terry Fader, and My Safe Ride Home. Friends don't let friends drive drunk.
The Cutie Fieldhouse. North scored the last 2 points of the first quarter, now have run off the first 3 of the second. And they lead it 21-19. South led most of the first quarter and ended up with a 1-point lead, 19-18, but now North has taken it back.
Well, first 2 minutes and 20 seconds, South 0 of 3 from the floor in quarter number two. So a good time out there for Coach Schultz.
Selk has it, and ball is tipped out of bounds by Dan Campion. Parise back in the game. Harrison, Selk, Jordan Jackson, Amundsen, and Schrader. Schrader going down baseline, reverse layup is good.
Nice move, man. He's 3 of 4 from the floor.
Ties up the game, too.
I said you're gonna have to have him have a big game.
He's got 8.
Ethan Guskey just 3 shot attempts tonight.
Amundsen being very tight. Oh, good steal by Selk. Taking it hard to the basket. Parise on the foul, preventing the easy layup. But good defense by Sam Selk. Sam is a sophomore also, as is Harrison and Matt Miller and Eric Tetchlog, who hasn't got seen action yet, but TJ Pitch also, we mentioned him earlier.
Yeah, they're talking to the South guys, they said, getting a little experience, getting a little better. Gotta make your free throws though.
2 for 4 for South on the night. Had a good start. Matt Schrader made 2, and then it's been going south since then.
Aye.
Did you get the pun?
I got her. There's the left-hander going left, right past Selk again. He doesn't learn quick, does he?
Parise, kick out to Campion. His shot is off. Harrison with a rebound.
His fourth.
Had a nice first half. Good swing of the ball. Selk open. He nails the 2.
There you go.
23-21. Southsiders. Mon inside. Missed layup. Felt the pressure. Schrader pushing it hard. Good play by Jordan Jackson to not put the ball on the court.
Yeah, he wasn't sure what he wanted to do with it, but I think you're right, he made the right decision.
Well, he's not a ball handler anyway. He probably would have traveled. Selk, kick out to Jackson, a left-hander. Can't get it in. Campion threw it right to Harrison, who missed the shot, and then Larson lost the ball. Schrader, hard to the basket for a layup. 25-21. Campion into Mon. His shot is off, no good.
Missed
he missed
2.
Another bunny. And he's coming out. Stengel to come in for him.
Connor Harrison having a nice half.
Guskey's gonna get called for a foul.
Dominic makes a living in the blue there. That's not very often you've seen him miss those.
Pitch Zeitz McLaughlin in. Jake Knuth also. A foursome for South. .325 left in the half. South up 25-21. Pace has been at a good one for South, I think, Chris.
Oh, I think it's fast.
Think so?
Yeah. I said if North gets to 60.
It got Pitch for a travel before the shot.
It's just the 4th turnover on South, where North already has 10.
That first quarter was a fast pace, being 19-18, but it has slowed down here in the second.
Yep.
Campion, shot is up and in. Nice inside fake. McLaughlin over to Amundsen. He just won't shoot the ball.
North just 2 of 9 shooting in the quarter.
Although in warmups I saw him take a couple shots.
He had like 8 rebounds the other day, Carter.
Well, I don't remember what your totals were on him in the last game, but it doesn't seem to me like he turns the ball over much. A little backdoor screen left McLaughlin wide open.
No,
again,
he got,
North not playing good defense.
No, it isn't, and I don't think Carter took a shot last game either.
But I just mean with his ball handling.
Right.
Kick out, Campion, bango, a three-pointer.
Well, credit Guskey on that one because he drawed three people, so that left Campion open, and he hit the shot to pull him within one.
He has seven. Nobody else, except for Guskey, actually has a basket, but nobody else has points. Parise, Hayes, and Stengel. And having said that, Parise now sits down and Larson comes in. And Mon is coming back in.
I think Lucas was in for about 5 seconds.
No, he was in for a little longer than that. He almost got a minute. You were only 55 seconds off. But that's okay. Guskey. Boy, oh boy, you know, it just seems like they're shooting, but they're never calling the foul on the shot.
Yeah, they called the shove before.
Seitz picks up the foul. That's the sixth team foul on South. There's 1:51 left in the half. Good defense by Seitz to cover up Guskey. They knew that double team was coming.
Oh, that's a double dribble. Oh, the whole play stopped because they thought it was a... and he just got away with it.
Hey, stuff happens.
All the players, I think, on the floor stopped. And Guskey just shot up.
Schrader open, couldn't get it in.
Didn't have his feet set.
And then we're gonna get a foul. I think Campion is gonna be shooting. It's a rebound foul.
Yep.
Seitz again.
Matt just didn't get himself set that. He got himself set, but then he kind of rushed it. No. The game is so fast that sometimes you don't get a chance to set yourself like you wanted to probably. That would have been a big three, though.
Yeah, oh, yeah, for sure.
Now North has a chance to take the lead.
Yep, they're down one. Campion rattled that one in. We'll say that one had the right string and the right yo-yo. The hoop didn't want it, but it did go down. That one was pure. 28-27 North. Pitch has it, goes to the basket, feeds it over to Knuth, who puts it off the glass and in. One 10, Campion on a floater to the basket, scores.
He's hit his last three shots, Danny, after missing his first.
Him and Larson with 11 each. North has got to hustle back. Under a minute. Amundsen being guarded by Hayes. Schrader, and he lost the ball out of bounds. He wants a foul. Campion was there, but they're not gonna call it. They're calling a foul. They're calling an offensive foul.
What?
I thought maybe he just lost the ball, but they're calling an offensive foul.
Wow, that was a tough call. I was gonna say that was the right call to just turn it over to the other team, but I didn't think it was a foul there. Oh.
Right, Sam Selk back in the game. 40 seconds left. North up by one. Guskey's been pretty silent here in the first half with only 2 points.
Yep, 1 of 4 shooting.
Again, Amundsen playing real tough defense following Guskey around.
See if Ethan gets the last shot though.
See if North pulls it out. No, Campion.
He's hot.
He is hot. Another three by Dan Campion. 33, 29.
Made his last four.
Under 10 seconds. Selk had his shot go off. Now they're gonna call a foul on Ethan Guskey. Selk. Salk will be at the line shooting a pair. I almost thought they were going to call basket interference. Salk with 3 points now. Oh, getting inside was Jake Knuth for an easy two. Lang at the buzzer, no good. And we're at halftime at South High School's Acuity Fieldhouse. Raiders lead at 33-32.
Making it green starts from the ground up, so make sure the air in your home is healthy for your family to breathe. Test your home for the presence of radon. Go to epa.gov/radon.
Make it green, green, green.
Time was, kids did what came naturally, spending free time running through the grass, exploring streams. But times have changed. Today's indoor kids spend more than 7 hours in front of electronic media. That's why National Wildlife Federation created the Be Out There movement. Outdoor play improves kids' health, body, mind, and spirit. It helps them stay fit, enhances creativity, and could even make them better students. There's a reason they call it the Great Outdoors. Learn more at beoutthere.org.
Be out there!
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the floor, the North High Drumline.
Thank you.
I'm Dr. Regina Benjamin, U.S. Surgeon General. Breastfeeding is a preventive measure that can protect babies from illnesses and infections, and there are also health benefits for mothers. While 75% of American mothers start out breastfeeding, only 13% of babies are exclusively breastfed at the end of 6 months, and the rates are much lower for African American infants. Whether you're a grandmother or an employer, you can help make it easier for moms to breastfeed. For more information, please go to surgeongeneral.gov.
The preteen years are a challenging time, but they're also a good time to think about your child's health, which is why, if you're the parent of an 11 or 12-year-old, you need to know about preteen vaccines. Vaccines that can protect your preteen from meningitis, whooping cough, and for girls, the virus that causes cervical cancer. So schedule a checkup for your child today and ask about preteen vaccines, because your preteen might think that they're grown up, but they're counting on you to know better.
Brought to you by DHHS and the CDC.
I can have text all night long, but not when I'm driving.
What's the point of texting me about a party that you might not make it to?
I don't text and drive.
Do you?
Do you?
Do you?
Did you say text or sex? Hey, I got an idea. As long as you're texting, why don't you write your own obituary, dumb?
I don't
text and drive.
Do you?
We don't text and drive. Do you?
Brought to you by Rad Terry Vader and his cast of thousands. Friends don't let friends text and drive.
Hardy!
Did you know early signs of eye disease and vision changes start to occur around age 40? I'm Dr. Ann Coleman for the American Academy of Ophthalmology. I see firsthand how vision problems can affect lives. We are urging adults to get a baseline eye disease screening at age 40. If you have any risk factors or signs of eye disease, see an ophthalmologist right away. Know your risks. Save your sight. To learn more, visit GetEyeSmart.org.
Back at North High School's Acuity Fieldhouse, where North leads at halftime, 33-32. Let's go through the scoring. Matt Schrader for South had 10 points. TJ Pitch had 5. Jake Knuth, 6. Sam Selk, 3. Cody McLaughlin, 2. Jordan Jackson, 2. And Connor Harrison, 4. For the Northsiders, their high score, Ethan Guskey had 2 points. Dan Campion had 14. Davis Larson had 11. Kevin Lang, 3, and Dominic Mon, 3. They've really held Guskey in check, Chris, but what are some other stats you have?
Kind of an interesting thing I have. Yeah, they held Ethan to 1 of 4 shooting. He's got just 2 points, like Marty mentioned. 13 of 29 shooting for North. 50% shooting for South, and you're losing the basketball game. The other interesting thing, South is just 1 of 9 from 3, but 13 for 19 from 2-point range, and a lot of that is getting easy baskets off the press. Well, interesting to see what happens there. Another interesting thing, North has more turnovers than South. More turnovers, less shooting percentage, but the bottom line, I thought, in that first half was offensive rebounds, as in the first half, 9 offensive rebounds for Sheboygan North.
North hit 3 of 5 free throws in the first half. South was 3 for 7. They've got to the line pretty much. South will be tossing it in. They've got their starters back on the court. Schrader, Knuth, Amundsen, Harrison, and Pitch. North also coming back with their starters, Campion, Guskey, Lang, Larson, and Mon. Over the crowd is Knuth, but he couldn't get the shot to roll in. Inside feed to Mon, he puts it up and in. He has 5 points on the night. Good help defense, preventing Pitch from going down the baseline. Kick out to TJ, his rainbow three is no good. Schrader with the rebound, and he throws it off a North player out of bounds.
Well, once again, going to that three-pointer, and for South, it's not been a good thing. They're now 1 of 10 from there.
Good help defense again by Dominic Mon.
I'm not saying don't shoot them, but I'm just
making them.
Gotta make some if you're gonna hang in here. That's just a lazy pack. Look, gotta be a little quicker, boys.
Campion fighting through the screen, trying to force Schrader down the baseline, but he didn't fall for it this time.
Long possession for South. Let's see if they get rewarded.
Schrader's jump shot from 13 is good. He has 12. Lang inside to Mon. Shot is off, no good. Lang, rebound, put back is good.
Another offensive rebound.
Larson with a kick. -34 North on top. For a team with only three wins, South has played quite well tonight.
Yep. Well, Jake can mention last week that the team has been getting better. If they could just put four quarters together, they're halfway home. They played two good ones.
Knuth from outside the line, round and down for Big Jake.
Jake now 4 of 7 from the floor.
Tied at 37, under 6 minutes left in the third. Larson, he nails a three, steps out and pops home a three. It's been a while since he scored.
And they answered. See, on the flip side, North is 5 of 9 from three.
Larson had 11 points all in the first quarter. Chris didn't score in the second, and now he's got a bucket here in the third. Amundsen wide open underneath. Rhythm bounce, up and in, and he's fouled, and we finally saw Carter take a shot.
I was just thinking the same thing, Marty. But that was from point blank range.
He's got a pretty good shooting percentage.
he's a really good athlete. He's just a super, super athlete. I think he could play just about any sport he wanted to and do well at.
And he finishes off the three-point play. It's all tied at 40. Parise in the game. Larson lean in, off the glass and in. Oh my.
He loves these North-South games. We only get to see him 6 more times. Knuth was wide open.
Schrader with a good fake. Guskey went for it, but couldn't pop in the two-point attempt. Well, he had a great look. Larson. Mon. Over to Guskey. We're going to get a foul. Not sure on whom.
Exactly. Who are they going to call this hustle one on?
Parise.
Really?
Jackson and Zietz in for South, and Kevin Lang in for North. North up 42-40. Schrader down the baseline, put it up and in. Too easy.
Well, they forced them that way, but I think they were waiting for some help, and they didn't get it this time. Normally, North's really good at that.
Guskey. Puts it in. Haven't heard from him in a while.
Nope.
Not since the first quarter.
Good decision there by Carter again.
Guskey playing off of Schrader. The other defenders for North are really up on their man, very tight. I think that shows respect for Matt and his ability.
Wow.
Kisses it off the glass and in.
Said he had to have a big game. He does so far.
16 points, Chris.
I was just going to say 7 of 10 shooting for him.
Foul on South. Mon will be at the line. It's going to go on Harrison, his second.
Connor had a great first quarter and then kind of got quiet a little bit in that second.
Been a bit of an adventure when Dominic goes to the line.
Harrison comes out. He had 5 rebounds in the first half. Couple of baskets.
South going a little short right now. Jordan Jackson, the only tall guy.
Dominic, 2 of 7 from the floor. 50% on that free throw. Trip.
1 for 2, 2 for 4 on the night.
See Dr. Sheehan's here tonight. I always like to see him come to these Sheboygan events.
Yeah. See with all his friends, like Jeannie Bitkers used to be.
Yep. He's with Tim Eyrick.
Okay. Got a full house up here in the booth with radio, 2 TV stations. Might have 2 radios up here.
Normally we do, only
and
one
scouting.
Today.
Scouters are up here.
That's just a bad pass there. You know, you want to come in a game, you can't throw passes from across the way there.
Falls on Zietz, his 3rd.
Yep, Matt Miller with a bounce pass, slow bounce pass. Turn the ball over. Excellent basketball game, Marty.
Yeah, it is very good. I think South is playing a nice game. Guskey, leaping leaner in the lane, couldn't get it in. Stengel got the rebound, but he was fouled before the shot. This will go on South. Falls on Jackson. Jake Knuth in. Taking Schrader out, and all of a sudden, South gets a little taller, Chris. Guskey.
Good cover up by Self.
Lean in, couldn't get it, got his own rebound, bumped, shoots, no good. And they're scrapping underneath.
Ethan trying to draw the contact there. I thought South did a nice job of just
staying there, right?
Yep.
I agree. Tie-up situation. Arrow points North's way, so they'll get it out of bounds.
We're gonna get a hold.
Selk with a grab. You know, with all that bumping and banging and crashing underneath the basket, and then you get that. And I'm not saying it was a bad call, but my goodness.
Grabbed his jersey.
That's all?
I'll tell you, South's done a nice job on North's out of bounds plays. Very well scouted and very well coached.
Campion.
Oh, that should have been a travel.
Another tie-up situation. This time South will get it.
I don't know. Campion
went down in an awkward way.
Yeah, he did.
Good
I
thing
was
he's coming up, getting
I was
up.
Concerned about that. It should be the North ball.
I believe there was a tie-up situation underneath the basket a little earlier, Chris. And they gave it to North, and this time on the tie-up, they're giving it to South.
Or are they?
Jim Larish at the table is asking the officials, what's up?
Yeah, we had that under the South basket over here. We had that tie up over
yeah,
here.
Yeah, there, but there was one underneath the North, and I didn't see him call a foul. They just gave the ball out to North, so I just figured it was a tie up, but nobody went like this. You know, they didn't signal anything to the table. That's why there'd be some confusion in that regard. Unless they called it somehow out of bounds. It looks like North is going to get it. You know what I really hate about all this? You were right again. I remember back in 2007 once though.
I'm quite wrong.
North ball out of bounds. Guskey.
Oh, created space.
And he makes a nice play.
Yeah, he created space with his body there and got the basket in. It's just 3 of 9 tonight shooting.
Miller back in the game. Selk has it on the wing.
Another bad pass by Miller. You're killing him, Matt.
Campion gets to the hoop. Reverse layup is good. A little change of direction. South defenders fell asleep. It's 49-44.
Another bad pass by Matt.
Oh, and in and out of bounds and no call. Shot by Knuth is way off.
I feel a little momentum swing. Here goes Campion for a bucket.
Oh, and he used a left hand, man. Campion was able to get his feet set and nailed a three. Have a ball game, Dan Campion. 52-44, and there is that run. It happened in the girls' game in the third quarter, and it's happening here in the third quarter. Campion with 19. WSCS is testing new equipment tonight that allows us to go live, and we would like feedback from you, our viewers, about how it is working. You can contact WSCS at 459-6663 Monday through Friday during regular work hours or through the station's website at WSCSSheboygan.com. We haven't talked about it much, but our next game is going to be next week, Thursday, February 7th, when Christian travels over to Lutheran for the second Holy War by the Shore. Also want to give out a shout to Bill Wagner, hoping you're getting well, and we want you back here at North High. Our crew tonight, our director is the boss, Kerry Kautzer, Richard Bartson, and Eric Wiesman on camera. Chris Wright is the color man, and I'm the play-by-play guy, Mike Martin. And we are enjoying bringing you this ball game. It's been a good one. Both of them have been very good.
I've heard a lot of texts about how bad our sound is, so I'm sure there'll be some people, but we got to get that cleaned up.
Yeah.
Everything
yeah.
else is good. Big run off two turnovers and a miss by South. North took advantage and all of a sudden sprang this lead to 8. The two Miller turnovers, and then Jake Knuth missed that leaner in there, and here goes the run. South needs a basket.
8-point run it's been for North. And Harrison throws it off of Larson out of bounds. There's 1:30 left in the third. Good spin move by Schrader. His shot is off, no good. Knuth with the rebound. He kind of lost it on the way up, Chris. Didn't get a good look at the hoop. Fast break. Lang couldn't get it in. Guskey gets fouled underneath. North will get it out of bounds. Let's see who the foul's on. Foul's on Pitch.
14 offensive rebounds for Sheboygan North. We're not even quarter number 5 yet.
Stengel kicks it out to a Campion. He nails another 3.
Wow.
Man alive, have a night, Dan Campion.
He's 8 of 11 from the floor.
Biggest lead of the night by either team, 11.
And he's made 7 of his last 8, Marty. Just like that. We were tied at 42, I see on your sheet.
Yeah, it's been a tough road, this possession. 2 for South. North really tightening up the screws on defense. Knuth charges. Oh, wow. He got a break on that one. Larson's going to get the foul. I thought for sure that Knuth charged, but it's not the way the official saw it. Jake will go to the line. Within a chance to break the run. Hey, do you got a computer? Why don't you use it? Hey, everything you got written down here is by hand.
I know.
It's a whole. Well, I get the information
off the computer.
Well, can you type? Of course,
hey,
your handwriting's pretty good. If I tried to write all that out.
Mine's poor, but.
Well, mine's terrible. I got to type stuff out. Bill Horsch yells at me when I give him those signs, you know, about when the replays are. 15 seconds left. 10-point game, North on top. Talk about lazy passes. There was one. Dusky says, clear it out for the man. And he gets fouled.
Nobody's up there taking a charge. You know he's coming. But let's just all leave our feet.
Harrison picks up his third.
42-42 at one time.
Yep, South had scored to tie it up at 42, and actually they tied it up at 44 also.
Okay, 44-44.
Goes back and forth down the sheet, and all of a sudden there's a whole bunch of numbers written on the north side. 45 on the Mon free throw, then 47, 49, 52, 55, and then two more free throws makes it 57. Pitch, fadeaway three. Can't get it to go, and we're at the end of three quarters of play. North on top, 57-45.
Engineers Without Borders USA answers the call with more than 225 university and professional chapters from a wide spectrum of disciplines. With more than 400 sustainable engineering projects in more than 45 countries, our organization is changing the world. If you would like to find out more about how you, too, can change the world, visit www.ewb-usa.org and click Get Involved. Engineers Without Borders USA, building a better world, one community at a time.
It is time for caring people everywhere to treat animals as more than mere property.
To be bred, bought, and sold at an owner's whim.
I urge you to adopt your next dog or cat at a local shelter or humane society.
Please, be a guardian, not an owner.
Back at North High School's Acuity Fieldhouse, where the Raiders ended that third quarter with a 13-2 run, and the score was tied at 44, and now it's 57. To 45, make that a 13-1 run. Knuth was only able to make one of those two free throws. North in a zone defense now, Chris. I thought their man-to-man was doing a pretty good job. Schrader's long shot is no good. Guski over to Larson for an easy two. North running the court. Like days of old.
Well, just 5 of 13 shooting for South in that quarter. North was 9 of 16, but 7 of 12 from 3 for North.
Pitch.
Finally gets one down.
Bombs one in. Campion with a leaner. Puts it up and in. He's got 24.
Wow.
Yeah, wow is right.
He's 8 of his last 9 shooting in quarter, the last three quarters.
It's 61-48, North up 13. Schrader slides through the defense with a nice drive and a hoop.
Well, you can't trade basket South.
No, Schrader has 16, he's having a nice night. Oh, there's a walk not called. Larson lean in.
And again, instead of Connor standing there and taking a charge, you look awkward too with your hand kind of slapping there. They're gonna call that foul, and they did.
Gonna get Jake Knuth on the foul.
Really?
Larson will be shooting a pair. Davis went to the line in the first quarter and missed his only free throw attempt of the game until now. So he's 0 for 2. knock this one home. Oops, tripped over a line. Well, I don't think backing up is gonna do it, Chris. You gotta dribble up a little bit, create something. Schrader open, his shot rims off. Guskey with the rebound. Lang with a three. A little bit of penetration by Campion created the opening.
North now 12 of 19 shooting in the second half.
I was gonna say, Chris, when we were here this morning setting up, North was had a little bit of a practice and they did that exact same thing. Dribble in a little bit, guy comes from the corner and you either keep driving it in or you pass it back depending on the situation. Obviously, Campion read it right.
Lang, that was his eighth, the team's eighth three-pointer as well.
Another thing working against South, Chris, is they have seven team fouls. North will be going to the line the rest of the game. Nice. Harrison on a lob pass.
Nice play. But again, it's got to be this end if the team in the black outfit here wants to come back.
Yeah, they got to play some defense.
Morris had three trips and three baskets. And that's a travel.
Larson couldn't get it, but he is fouled. Connor Harrison will pick up that foul, and that'll be his fourth. Larson has 19 points. Campion 24. Schrader has 18 for South. Jake Knuth has 10 for South also. Guskey, the leading scorer coming into tonight's game, only has 8. Jordan Jackson, ill-advised three attempt by him. Larson had it tipped away by Jackson and it goes off of Davis Larson's hand. South will have it.
I got Ethan Guskey for 6 rebounds already.
He's been, he gets up in the air really well. He's a good jumper. You can tell he's worked on his vertical. And he's really not that small of a guy. You look at his arms and shoulders, he's put together. Schrader with a nice move again.
Oh, and another timeout for South.
That's okay, because now we got to flip the sheet over.
I was going to say, though, might need those.
All right, it's a full timeout, Kerry. There's 4:38 remaining. South up 12, North up 12.
Hi, I'm Mia Hamm. As a professional soccer player, I know how rewarding sports can be and how quickly injuries happen. So I've teamed up with the American Association of Orthodontists to ask athletes to play it safe. With my years of training, I know what it takes to become an expert, and orthodontists do too. They're the experts who help people obtain healthy, beautiful smiles. Wear mouth guards, face masks, and helmets to prevent injuries. Keep smiling and visit braces.org.
At North High School's Acuity Fieldhouse. It's been a back and forth action here in the fourth quarter, and as far as the Southsiders go, that's not good enough. They need to get some stops. One thing they haven't done too much of, Chris, is force North into turnovers for easy baskets.
No, that's one of the keys. Well, one of my keys tonight was offensive rebounds, and that was number one, and 14 offensive rebounds for North. Another one was once North gets 60 plus points, that's a good thing. They're at 66.
I think the biggest is North-South is only at 54.
Right, and I said South needs to put four scoring quarters together, and that third quarter was a bugaboo for them.
Guskey kick out to Larson. Couldn't get it in.
Oh, another.
Lang with a rebound. Inside feed to Stengel, and then he's held by Jake Knuth. That'll be Jake's second foul. But again, North commanding the rebounds.
I have Davis Larson with 10 rebounds for North, along with his 20 points. 20 points and 10 rebounds as a freshman.
Yeah.
Holy cow.
Really? Schrader backs it out, North in his own. Schrader left open, he fires up a three but can't get it, but Tyler Zietz comes away with the rebound. Reload for the south side. Oh, nice play by Davis Larson. Guskey with an easy two. He's got 10 on the night.
There was one of those easy baskets, Marty.
Yeah, that's what South wants to get. Zietz forces it and not a good shot attempt. Guskey.
Another easy basket.
Nope. He wanted it, sensed it, but couldn't get it in. And Schrader, sweet. Oh, man. He has 22. What a night.
Yeah, we needed Matt to have a good game, and he did.
Stengel's shot is blocked by Jackson. South comes away with it. And we're going to get an offensive foul on Schrader. Guskey took a good swipe at the ball, and that's what the fans saw, but they didn't see Schrader push off.
I think that's the first time Ethan and Matt have met each other.
I don't think so.
In their basketball career.
This may be the last time, though. Guskey coming off a double screen. Amundsen again playing the good D. Larson cleans up inside for an easy two.
Another offensive rebound.
Knuth off the glass. Knuth. 2:25 left in the ball game. North up 12. And Mann not able to handle a pass, lost it out of bounds. Lucas Hayes comes in for Dominic.
First half, North had 10 turnovers. That's their first one in the second half.
Really? Oh, boy.
That's another reason why you're
right,
in front.
Yeah. You're always getting attempts.
Yep.
Shot attempts.
10 turnovers in the first half for North. That's number one with 2:19 left in the fourth.
Hayes with a silly foul.
Just the 15 foul for North. Nick Rudolph gonna get in the game here. Boy, we haven't seen him all game.
Yeah. Nick Rudolph, a sophomore coming in. He was moved up several weeks ago when they found out Hameister wasn't gonna be coming back.
The North student section starting to feel the game.
Slipping away for South, eh?
Yep.
Harrison for two. And finally, South has two baskets in a row, Chris.
Yeah, like I said, they gotta do it on this end.
Under 2 minutes. Oh, wow. Guskey forcing it there. Turns it over. Their second turnover. Come on, Ethan, you're better than that.
You gotta hurry here, Tyler. You're only down 10. Get a three-pointer or something here.
Yeah,
Matt's open.
Seems like it should be a lot more, doesn't it, Chris?
Another bad pass.
Oh, Rudolph dribbles it off his foot.
See, I shouldn't have said anything about them turnovers. Now they got three in a minute.
Jared Parise is going to come in.
You know, if South could get a quick score and then maybe a quick steal in a basket, but they got to hurry.
1:25 left. Schrader squares up, couldn't get it. Guskey, he wants two, and he gets it. Has 12. Shot by Pitch is down. That's a 9-point game, Chris. 72-63, 106 left. It's a 30-second timeout, so we'll keep it here. Guskey has 12. Campion 24. Larson 22. For Saul, Schrader has 22. Knuth has 12. Connor Harrison, 8. TJ Pitch has 11. Pretty good balance on both sides of the ledger, Chris. But boils down to that third quarter.
Yeah, 5 of 13 shooting in that third quarter for South. And like I said, one of my points is putting four scoring quarters together in a row, and they just couldn't do it. A couple turnovers, and a missed basket, and then Danny Campion was just on fire. There's Danny, number four, with the ball.
Larson gets fouled.
Gonna have to make, or excuse me, gonna have a chance at two free throws because it's double bonus, Marty.
I was just looking at that third quarter scoring. North had 24 points in the quarter, and to South's 13.
And it was 44-44.
Yep, it was 44-44 at one point, and it was a 13-1 run that Ooh. Broke the game open in the middle to the near end of the third.
And North hitting some free throws.
Now their free throw percentage is not going to be good. Schrader.
Oh.
Parise had a good grab on the arm. The official didn't see it. And Zietz on a foul. Tyler Zietz with 4. 45 seconds left.
North 9 of 14 from three-point range. South just 5 of 18. Another difference.
Oh, Campion, he's making everything. He has 26. That's got to be a career high. TJ Pitch, no good. Clock running, 30 seconds left. Ball tipped out of bounds. 75-63.
Good game.
Yes, it was. Third quarter proved fatal for the Red Wings. Pitch buries a three, another timeout by South.
A little too late, and yeah. A timeout too late.
Pitch has 14.
As I mentioned before, that puts them at 30%. Shooting from three, they're 6 of 20. North, 9 of 14 from there. Overall shooting for North, they are 27 of 55, almost 50% from the floor.
So far in the quarter, South has 20 points, North 18, and right there is the reason why South has not been able to get the deficit down. They've allowed North to score on a pretty much an equal basis here in the fourth. Quick foul on Knuth. His third, Guskey will be at the line. Ethan's pretty good on his free throws, Chris. Ethan buries one.
Yeah, he's just shot 5 of 13 tonight from the floor, but did get 6 rebounds.
Twelve of 19 free throws, not that bad, Chris. I thought it was worse. 13 of 20. Under 20 seconds left. Get these slipping in the game for North was Dominic Butson, number 15. Also in the game is number 23, Michael Baca. We haven't seen either of those young men. Harrison, Knuth, Schrader, Pitch, and Zietz on the floor for North. Schrader makes a free throw there. That gives him 23 on the night, looking for 24. Sixty-eight. North with 77, and that's going to be the basketball game. North the winner. 77-68. Leading scorers were Campion with 26 and Schrader with 24 for South. With the win, North runs their record to 16-3, 10-3 in conference. South drops to 3-16 and 3-10 in conference. It was a good night for the Northsiders. South battled them hard, but couldn't quite keep up. That third quarter, like we mentioned before, was the difference. We're going to take a break. When we come back, Chris will do a couple interviews, and Chris is down there already, so we can maybe take a short break, Kerry, and come back.
I assess the needs of a community to make sure that our work will be sustainable.
We are working to change the world, to make it a better place.
Through our sustainable engineering projects, thousands of members in more than 225 universities and professional chapters work to support these efforts in over 45 countries.
To find out more about how you can get involved, go to www.ewb-usa.org and click Get Involved.
Build a better world with us.
Build a better world with us.
Build a better world with us, one community at a time.
Hey, we're back here, Two Raiders. Ethan, one thing South hasn't done all year is put four quarters of scoring together. Today they had three of them again, and it was that third quarter that made the difference. You really shut them down in that third.
Yeah, I mean they were killing us on the press. We weren't very good on our weak side, but you know, we're lucky we had Dan Campion to give us that push in that third quarter.
Yeah, exactly right. I thought the press, they got a lot of easy baskets off that stuff. Seems like, you know, good throws by Carter Robinson, a couple of those guys to get some open looks, and it didn't work at first. But interesting stat, in the first half, you guys had 10 turnovers. You didn't have a turnover till like 2 minutes left in the second half, so you really took care of the ball, too, in that second half.
Yeah, that first quarter, it was ugly. I mean, we were getting our rebounds and we were getting turnovers, but then we couldn't capitalize off that, getting fast break points. Instead, we were turning it right back over to them.
You twisted your ankle on an official?
Yeah, as I took one three, I stepped back, and the ref was right there. I actually thought it was the South coach, but I looked and I thought it was the official, but
I thought you were just trying to draw an R foul or something.
I was hoping maybe you'd call it on him finally.
Another nice win. It was a great battle. It was really a fun game there up until you guys just went on a huge run in that third quarter. But, I mean, you gave the fans a great show, that's for sure.
Yeah, North-South game, you never know what can happen, but they sure gave us a run for their money.
I'm going to ask you, I've asked you this question before, North-South week, experiences of this week, how it's different than any other week?
I mean, you grow up playing against these guys, and you kind of get to know them pretty well. And, you know, a huge crowd, you know, excitement in the game, fans love it. It's nothing like it.
Yeah, once Tuesday night's game over, it's just big focus on this or things like that? Or
yeah, I mean, we kind of get excited, you know, like a week in advance. But, I mean, as soon as that Tuesday night game was done, I mean, we were right on south.
Well, congratulations. We'll see you shortly. Danny had a big night. Everything seemed to be going in for you.
Yeah, I hit some shots early, and I decided to keep shooting. Worked out tonight.
Yeah, I think you hit like 8 of 9 shots in a streak there. So everything was going in, and then your free throws are going in. So gotta have love nights like that.
Yeah, good shooting nights make it a lot easier. Makes you want to play defense harder. Just makes you want to play the game more.
One of the big things I thought you guys did, one of my keys was offensive rebounds. All years you guys have been pounding the boards. I had you guys for like 16 offensive rebounds again. I mean, those second opportunities are just awesome.
Yeah, Coach really stressed offensive rebounding because I believe we're second in the conference in rebounding. For being a small team, that's really big for us. And coming into the year, everyone was questioning our size, and rebounding turned out big for us this year.
Definitely a big thing there. And definitely big changes of how things turned out there. Let's talk to you a little bit about what do you think of this North-South experience and stuff? How has it been for you over the last 4 years?
I absolutely love playing South. It's probably the funnest game of the year. Everybody's excited. The pep rally, you don't really get that much. And it's just a great feeling to go out with probably the last one, unless we see them in the playoff as a win.
Now, do you guys do a dinner or something last night, or do you do anything different today than normal games?
Last North-South game, we went to Schultz's, but this North-South game, we ended up going to Kevin Lang's house, and his mom made pasta, which was very excellent. and we always have a team get-together before North-South to make it a team event. It really is.
Yeah, we go to Schultz's after baseball games, after wins. How was that lasagna? Maybe some recipes and stuff being passed around there? Are you guys talking about that? So when you guys off to school and stuff next year?
Maybe. I would love to have Mrs. Lang come with me and cook for me in college.
We'll see what she can do. Yeah. Well, congratulations, gentlemen. It was a nice victory and a very exciting game for all the community of Sheboygan. With that, we'll send it back to Marty.
Final score was 77-68, North a winner. Our next basketball game is going to be Thursday, February 7th, when Christian invades Lutheran for the second Holy War by the Shore this season. For the crew, our director, Kerry Kulitzer, Eric Wiesman, and Richard Bartson on camera. For my partner, Chris Wright, I'm Mike Martin, saying thanks for watching, everybody, and we'll see you down the road.